Hello students, in the previous lecture we discussed the degree of kinematic indeterminacy of beams. Now let us go through the degree of kinematic indeterminacy of pin jointed structures. As we know, pin jointed frames are classified into two types: two dimensional, that is 2D pin jointed frames, and 3D pin jointed frames, which are respectively also called as plane pin jointed frame and space pin jointed frame. Now in case of pin jointed frames, there are three basic assumptions which are always assumed, are like this. First, the loading is always applied at the joints only. Second, all the members of a pin jointed frame are considered as straight. And third, the self weight of all the members is neglected. So with these three assumptions, the pin jointed plane frames are supposed to carry only axial forces in its members. So every member of a pin jointed frame carries axial force. Because of those three assumptions, the loads are acting at the joints, all the members of a pin jointed frame are straight, and self weights of all the members are neglected. So every member carries an axial force. As such, shear force and bending moment are absent in case of the members of a pin jointed frames, and no joint is subjected to rotation. So every joint in a two dimensional pin jointed frame has two independent displacement components, that is delta x and delta y, that is displacement along x direction and displacement along y direction. So these two orthogonal displacement components are there in case of a 2D frame. Similarly, in case of 3D frame, there are three independent displacement components, that is delta x, delta y, and delta z. So two displacement components in case of 2D frame, and we say that every joint in case of 2D frame has a 2 degrees of freedom, whereas in case of a 3D frame, every joint has 3 degrees of freedom. So if there are j number of joints, let us consider the plane pin jointed frame. So if there are j number of joints, the total number of displacement components which are possible are 2 times j, because 2 is the number of displacement components at each joint, and if j is the number of joints, this becomes 2j, minus the number of displacement components which are restrained, and this restraint takes place because of the reaction components provided by the support system, and that is why decay in case of plane pin jointed frame is given as 2j minus r, whereas in case of 3 dimensional, that is 3D pin jointed frame, it is given as 3j minus r. So 2j minus r for plane pin jointed frame, 3j minus r for the space pin jointed frame. Now let us go through examples of this type. Now I am considering the examples of plane pin jointed frame. So I have shown two trusses. Let us go through the first truss. Now dk is given as 2j minus r. So we will have to calculate the number of joints. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 number of joints are there. So 2j becomes 2 times 8. Minus r. R is the number of reaction components. It is a roller support, it is a hinge support. So one reaction component over here, two reaction components over here, total is 3. So 2 into 8 minus 3 is 13. So 13 is the degree of kinematic indeterminacy for this given truss. Now, if the degree of kinematic indeterminacy for this truss is to be obtained, again, we will have to count the number of joints. 1, 2, 3. 4, 5, 6 are the number of joints. So 2 times j is 2 times 6 minus number of reaction components. There are these supports. So here 1 and 2. So it makes 4. So 2 into 6 minus 4, that is 8. So dk is equal to 8. So degree of kinematic indeterminacy in this case is equal to 8. So this is how we can get the degree of kinematic indeterminacy. It is a simplest type of problem as far as degree of kinematic indeterminacy is considered. In the next lecture, I am going to discuss the degree of kinematic indeterminacy of the frames in which rigid joints are there. So please stay connected and do subscribe to my channel. Thanks.